For our last 10, 11 minutes here, I'd like to talk generalities about autonomous equations. Autonomous diffeqs in general. Let's go back to using y and t. dy dt equals, what's autonomous mean? It means the right-hand side only depends on the dependent variable, in this case, y. Say f of y. No t's on the right-hand side. There could be other constants like m or g or k, but no t's. This is an autonomous differential equation. The right-hand side only depends on y. To think about approaching such a situation in general, the first thing to remember here is that the slope field is going to be constant along horizontal lines. Slope field is constant along horizontal lines. Why? Remember how slope fields are made. Think with me here. So t is horizontal, y is vertical. At each point in the ty plane, you plot a little line segment with slope given by what you get when you plug the point t comma y into the right-hand side. But if that only depends on y, no t's, then those slope marks are going to have constant slope along a horizontal line where y is constant and it doesn't matter what t is. And in fact, because of that, there's a nice technique for drawing the slope field fairly quickly without even plugging a bunch of numbers into here. You can just think about it. Based on the graph of this right-hand side function as an ordinary graph, I'm going to label the axes of this plane with the letters y and dy dt equals f of y. Something we hardly ever do, right? You've never seen axes labeled this way, probably. What am I going to draw? I'm going to draw the graph of f of y as if I'm not even bothering to think about differential equations. Just draw the graph of that function as an ordinary graph. Maybe it looks like this. Kind of like a cubic, perhaps. Maybe this is -3 here, and this is +2 right there, say. What would solutions of the differential equation look like if this is the graph of this right-hand side function? If it were an f of t on the right-hand side, and we were graphing this as a function of t, you'd be integrating a cubic to get a fourth degree. But that's not what's going on here. It's got an f of y. It's different. In fact, when y is -3 or 2, where this function equals 0, that's where you're going to have equilibrium solutions at those values of y. In another plane, a ty plane, you're going to have equilibrium solutions when y is -3 down here or +2 up here. The y-axis is horizontal here and vertical here. We're used to it being vertical. This is weird. But if you think about it, it makes sense. Along these two lines, your slope marks are going to have zero slope because the output of this function on the right-hand side will be zero for those values of y. You're going to have equilibrium solutions. If you take DiffQ with linear in the fall, we do this kind of thing a lot in that class. Two equilibrium solutions. Yes, y is horizontal here and vertical here. Don't let it bother you. It's not a big deal. It doesn't matter whether you make an axis vertical or horizontal. You can do what you want. We're just used to certain things. This is a big difficulty for people, though. I know it. How would you draw the rest of the slope field? What if you're trying to draw slope marks in this region here, where y is between -3 and 2? Because this graph is positive between -3 and 2, that means dy dt is positive when the initial condition is between -3 and 2. In other words, the slope field has to have positive slopes in here. And in fact, it's going to be highest positive slopes when y is close to, say, -1, like right about there. and y is close to negative 1, that's where your slope marks are going to have the highest possible positive slope, because that's where the output of this function is highest in this region. When you get close to negative 3 or close to positive 2, the slopes get close to 0 because the output of this function gets close to 0. So up here, you're going to have slopes closer to 0, but still positive. Same kind of thing down here. And your solutions are going to look like this. When y is less than negative 3, down here in this picture, that means you're to the left of negative 3. And the output of the right-hand side function is negative, meaning slopes of solutions are negative. You got to draw negative slopes down here. Fairly close to 0 when you're close to negative 3, but steeper when you're further away. And your solutions look like that. When y is above 2, up here, in this picture, y is over here, the output of this function is positive, meaning solutions have positive slopes. Close to 0 when you're just above 2, but then you're getting larger as you get higher away from 2, and your solutions look like this. Turns out both of these equilibrium solutions are technically unstable. This one, because nearby solutions go away in both directions. This one is because solutions that start above it go away from it as t increases. So these are both not stable, they're unstable. Yes, this is a difficult thing for people to get over, this hangup of going between these graphs. This is not a solution. This is not a solution to the differential equation. It just helps us draw a solution. That's all. That's all it is. You can look at this graph, and if you understand what's going on, it helps you draw this. These are the solutions. Doesn't mean we can find formulas for these things easily, except for the equilibrium solutions. I could theoretically separate variables, but doing the integral after doing such a thing might be really, really hard. And even if you can do the integral, solving for y as a function of t might be even harder. But I can still say what solutions look like. It's called a qualitative approach to differential equations. All right, have a good weekend.